गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, सो वी विल स्टार्ट टुडेज क्लास. So in the last class we had completed what is meant by metal casting, what are the different types of casting processes are there, what is meant by sand casting, what are the different types of molds, what is the type of shape and size can be made from the casting process, and what are the steps in the standard casting. So those are the topics which were discussed in the last class, right? So and we had also discussed related to the factors which are considered in the casting process. On what factors the casting process is to be get chosen, on how it is to be get started, whether it is for a small production or a large production. So it depends on the type of size and shape of the product, how you are going to be choosing, and on which day you are going to be delivering. So related to those topics we had taken a class in the last class. So in today's class we will learn about what are the testing molds and a core sand. I think we have completed up to this one. So we'll start from what are the testing of molds and a core sand. So testing of mold and a core sand. It explains that so testing of the mold and a core sand. So it explains that what type of mold you are going to be taken. So what type of test can be done for a mold and test can be done for a sand. So you are going to be choosing a green sand. So how the green sand is there and what is the properties of the green sand. So we have to check whether the green sand is having the same properties or some of the properties are to be get changing. So how the green sand was. So if you are getting, if you are going to take some patterns, you have to be check whether the pattern is in a correct manner or not. If you are going to be taking some molds, we have to check it whether it is in a correct way or not. So how we are going to be checking, what are the different types of process are going to be taking carried out. So as we know, they are going to be taken different types of non-destructive testings, so which we had seen the seminar in our college also. So what are the different types of non-destructive testings can be done, so to check the so and so work pieces or to check the so and so molds or a core sand. So what are the different types of test can be take over. So the first one is the preparation of a standard test specimen. So what is the preparation of a standard test specimen? So if you are going to be manufacture the test specimen with the help of some of the material, so you think the pattern is made up of a wax, so how it was prepared with the wax. So whether you are going to be taken chosen all the different types of tolerances, dimensions perfectly or not. So how the test specimen was there, so how the wax mold was taken, so how the wax piece pattern was to be get designed, so whether you had followed the correct process or not. So what is the preparation of that one. So the next one is mold hardness test. So the molds which we are going to be using, so it is to be get checked under all categories, under all categories, whether it is having a correct hardness, toughness, strength, and it is have, can the mold can be get sustain more amount of green sand or not, can be in a position to hold a more amount of patterns or not. So what is the size, whether the mold is reused more time or it is a fresh mold. So what is the properties it is going to happen? If the mold is to be placed, it is to be get heated at a certain temperature. Can the mold can be taken that much temperature? Because it is a used, the mold is used. So is the mold can be taken for a such temperature or not? So what are the different defects we are going to be getting from that mold? So you have to check what are the different properties are having for the mold. So whether it is there or not, or it is any defects are there for a certain thing. So next one is core hardness test. So core hardness, you are going to be, core is nothing but what is a sand core which you are going to be taken. So is the sand is of very small granules or it is may become a very large granules. So how it is going to be taken? So in the last class I have told you there will be different types of steps of jalis will be there. So each and every sand was to be poured on the first basin. So with the help of some analysis, so all the basins is to be get filled. So which is known as a sieve analysis. It is known as a sieve analysis. I will show the diagram. Wait a second. I think it is there in your foundry lab or not. I don't know. So this is the sieve analysis basins. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. So we will used to see in your homes. So what type of basins your mother used to be get used to pour some rice straws, so any rice grains or any other thing. So these are the basins which are used in your molding also. In your industry, these are the basins that we get used so that we are going to be separating the sand. What type of fine grain sand you are going to be getting, or else what type of granule sizes you are going to be getting. So this is the thing what is going to be happen in your industry. So the process is, yeah, this is the process. So this is the process. The first, second, third, fourth, fifth, and sixth. It depends on the material of the sand, whether the sand is very pure or not. It is having some mixture. So it depends on the sand, the number of basins are to be get chosen. If it is not having that much large granules, it's better to take a four type of basins. No need of these much basins. Clear? It is not a standard. It depends. So if it is a very large mesh, the first one is a very large mesh. So these type of granules can be get collected. These type of granules can be collected. So after collecting these type of granules on the first basin, the remaining sand will be flow to the second part. So in the second part, if the some granules are left over on the second part, it explains that these are the somewhat large. And again, the sand is automatically pours up to the last pan. Up to the last pan, it is no, nothing was there, nothing is to be get stopped here. These basins are connected one over the other. It is not play, it is just placing one over the other, and it is connected to a holder. It is not placing and it is not putting some stand or any other thing. It is just placed to a holder and it is attached to one thing, one machine. So in the second basin, this type of sand granules. In the third basin, one type, and the fourth, the small, and the fifth is a very small, and the sixth, the large, is the last is the very fine mesh. This is nothing but a pan. It is not having a basin. It is a pan where you are going to be collecting. So you can observe that when some masons are going to be building a house. So when the house was built, how the sand was to be get having a fine finish, fine mesh. So whether you are going to be getting a very smooth sand, very hard one, which is having a very small stones, large stones, or any other thing. So how it is to be get done? So that is nothing but which is the process used in your industry also. So why this process is to be get carried out means because the sand here using are on the sand casting or any other casting purpose, whether it is a shell molding or any other thing, we are putting a fine grains. We are not putting a very large grains, so that some of the thing are to be having binding on the sand particles. So if we are going to be using a large grains, what happens where the total grains having some spaces, the ramming cannot be done perfectly, so moisture content, the gas content, which is more and more, and there is a very air holes is going to be happen in between also. So for this way, for that sake, you are going to following the sieve analysis process. This is the best process which is to be get followed in your industry. Clear? So the next one. See students, so is it clear what is meant by sieve analysis? So the next one. So what is the moisture content test on a foundry sand? On a foundry sand. So when you are going to be taking a green sand, what you will do? You are pouring some water and you are going to be binding that one. You are doing some process on the sand. So why that process is to be get done? Why not the hard sand can be get used? We are going to be adding something like a water or any other content to the sand, so that it can be having some sticky nature. So what type of moisture content was there, whether the moisture content is enough to complete your process or not. So or else you have to be add something the part for your sand. So the sieve analysis, what just we had seen. So what is a clay content test? So already you know that the green sand consists of some clay and water. So what type of clay is used in your green sand? At the same time, how much percentage of clay was used, whether the percentage is in a correct manner or not. So why these tests are to be get done is it totally reflects on your workpiece. Totally reflects on your workpiece. If the percentages was not done correctly, if the process is not done correctly, what happens? The last is nothing but a product. The totally it depends on the product. So the failure comes on the product only. We can't see here, but the failure directly on the product. So not to get the failure of the product, we have to check each and every part. Clear? So what is the permeability test and what is the compression and what is the shear test? So each and everything is going to be done for a mold and a core sand. Clear students? So these are the testings are to be get done. So the next one is, so in the last class you had seen what is meant by sand casting. So you already know what is meant by sand casting, which you have learned in your second year. So other expandable mold castings. So what are the other expandable mold castings? What type of materials can be used? What type of molds can be get prepared? What type of risers? What type of sprues? Gates systems? What type of patterns are to be get used? So in your house, yes, you have to see the polyester, the plaster of Paris. The plaster of Paris molds you had seen. So how the plaster of Paris molds are to be get prepared? So how it is to be get attached? Because it is one of the luxury to attach something in plaster of Paris on your building, because it shows somewhat a good look, good appearance. So how it is to be, how they are going to manufacture that type of molds? So what is the care they had taken? What is the pattern they had taken? So when you want to go and buy a plaster of Paris piece, it cost a very much. So why the cost is that much? So what is the process is going to be taken? So the each and every it comes under the casting only. So what are the other expandable mold casting is? The one is the shell molding, vacuum molding, expanded polystyrene process, investment casting, and plaster and a ceramic mold casting. So as per your syllabus, these are the main thing. Not up to the part also, but it is a main thing. What is the shell molding and what is the investment casting? What is the plaster casting? So these are the main part which we'll be having in your syllabus. Clear? So the first, we will go to the first thing. What is meant by a shell molding? So what are the steps in a shell molding? So by the name shell, you know what is a shell. So by the name shell explains that it is going to pouring some molten metal inside a pattern. So pattern is not here a wood or any wax or any other thing. So how the process is going to be get done? Clear? So this is the diagram. The first one is shell molding casting yields better surface quality and tolerances. So the process is described as follows. The first one, a two-piece pattern is made of a metal, example aluminium or steel. So here the pattern is made up of an aluminium or a steel, any of the metal. So which is heated to between 175 degrees to 370 degrees Celsius and coated with a lubricant. Clear? Firstly, a pattern is going to be taken of a metal, of a certain metal, and it is to be get heated to 175 degrees to 370 degrees, and it is coated with a lubricant. For example, as a silicone spray, it was coated with a lubricant. So that is the first one. So in a shell molding, we have to see that, we have to note a point is, it made up of two half patterns. It is not a single pattern. It is made up of a two pieces in a shell molding. Clear? So next, the each heated half pattern is covered with a mixture of a sand and a thermoset resin or a epoxy binder. So each heated half pattern is covered with a mixture of a sand and a thermoset resin or an epoxy binder. So this is the first diagram. In the first diagram, we are placing some pattern or on a mold. So this pattern was heated up to some degrees, for some degree. So this pattern is made up of some metal like an aluminium or a steel. So in the below of that basin, we are going to putting some sand, which is having a resin binder consistence also. So after heating purpose, what is going to happen is the mold is to be get tilted. It is rotated. It is tilted. So it is a second position. It is tilted in a downward direction so that the pattern was very heated. The pattern was very, very heated. So the sand which is going to be attached on the pattern will be get attached directly only. It is to be get attached. So the next one is when it is to be get rotated, some binding consistence with the help of a resin, it is to be get attached to the mold, the pattern, what you have going to be get taken. So again, we are going to be turning the mold. We are going to be turning the mold. So see where, what is the type of shape they had got. So some of the thing, some of the type of granules are attached to that one. So which is nothing but the shell type is to be get formed. Clear? That is nothing but the binder glues a layer of a sand to the pattern forming a shell. So I had told you here we are in the first stage, we are going to be using a sand with a resin binder. So the binder is in a position to, it is having a sticky nature. So that when it is going to be adding, sticking to some other thing, it will be get attached like that only. So it is having a, some glue nature, glues a layer of a sand to the pattern. So forming a shell, the process may be repeated to get a thicker shell. So the process repeated means the second diagram is to be get rotated continuously until the binding is to be get existed in a correct part. Clear? One time rotation, it can't be. So it is to be get rotated two or three times so that it can be having a good. So the next one, the assembly is baked to cure it. So the next one, this part is to be the pattern which was attached a binding consistent is to be get taken into the baking system. Is to be taken into the baking system and it is to be get baked. So the patterns are removed and the two half shells join together to form the mold. So this is the first process. 1, 2, 3, 4. It is the first process. The same process is to be get repeat again. Is to be get repeat again because it is a shell molding. So in a shell molding, you are going to be taking a two half pieces, two half patterns. So this is the first half pattern. So again, repeat the same process. You will get the second half pattern. So the fifth diagram is when the total pattern was removed, the first half pattern, the binding resistance of the piece is to be taken off. It is to be taken off. So the same piece you will going to be getting when the second process is to be get followed. When the same process is to be get followed. So see the sixth diagram. So how it is? In the sixth diagram, the total two, the shell parts, it is to be get attached with the help of a clamp. With the help of a clamp. And the two shells are to be placed in a flask. Placed in a flask. And between the part, it is going to be having some space where we are going to be poured some metal. Where you are going to pour some molten metal. So what type of piece you are going to be want. So that type of molten metal is to be get poured. So after some time, the total, it is to be get removed from the flask. So the clamp is to be get removed. So each and every shells are to be get removed, and therefore the seventh one is the final part. Clear? The when after the metal is to be get solidified, you know, after what is to be happen in the sand casting. So the same process is to be done in this also. So after the metal is to be get solidified, so what happens? Break the, it is to be get break each and every part removed. So the seventh point is the final part. Clear, students? So this is the process which is carried out in a shell molding. In a shell molding, the first one, it is to be used in a two type process, because the first process half of the pattern, the second process is also half of the pattern. So the process is, firstly, the pattern made up of aluminium or steel, it is to be heated. Maybe in the bottom, if the sand consists of a resin binder, so it is placed on a one molding box. So again, the total box is tilted into the second part. So this tilting is to be get done 2 to 3, 4 times, so that what is the binding which is having a glue layers are to be get sticking on the pattern. Yes, friends. So after the third point, the fourth point is automatically the pattern which had a binding sticky nature which is attached to that one, it is placed in the baking consistent, baking part, baking basin. So after some temperature it was baked, and after that removing, so the pattern is to be get removed and the shell is to be get removed. So the same process we have followed the second time also. So you will get the two shells. So it is to be placed in a box. So it is to be get connected with a clamp, and the between them a space is to be there, and a molten metal is to be get poured into this shell. So after the molten metal is to be get solidified, it is the total pattern is to be get break. The box is totally wet break, and finally you will get the seventh point. Clear? So this is the steps in a shell molding. Okay. So we will see. So next one. So what is the advantages of that one? What is the advantages? Why you are going to be using a shell molding? Because it is having a smoother cavity with a surface, permits easier flow of molten metal and better surface finish on casting. It is very smooth because you are not having a you are not using a direct patterns. You are using some shells, so it is having a good dimensional accuracy. So surface finish is good and dimension accuracy is good. So machining often not required. So machining often explains that like a super finishing operations or a turning or a finishing operations or a fine finishing operations, any other operations cannot be get required because it is automatically having a some surface finish as a good and the dimension accuracy was good. So whatever the tolerances you want to be get required on your workpiece, it can be directly put on the design. Next, the mold collapsibility usually avoids cracks in the casting. So by using this part, it can be avoid the cracks. So whatever the defects you are going to be getting in the casting, it can be avoided up to some extent, because by use of the pattern, you are not preparing the mold, you are not preparing the part. So you, the pattern is to be get heated and the binding is to be get attached, after that again baking. So the two times baking is to be get done, so that the heat treatment was to be get carried out in the middle only. So the each and every bindings is to be having a good consistent. So the main advantage is mold collapsibility usually avoids cracks in a casting. So can be mechanized for mass production. So it can be used for a mass production. Clear? And the disadvantage is more expensive metal pattern. It is having a very more expensive, because it is a very lengthy process. Lengthy process, and it is to be get repeated again and again. So it is difficult to justify for the small quantities. So it can't be used for a very small pieces. It can be used for a somewhat very large pieces, some pipe adjustments, somewhat different ball bearings or any other thing. So for that type, we can be get used. So we will see what is the video. Okay. So see, students, we will see what is the one by one process is to be get carried out. So this is a pattern made up of an aluminium or any other thing, metal. In the first part, the pattern is to be placed in a basin. It is to be heated 175 to 370 degrees Celsius, and it is tilted. The basin consists of the resin bind with the binder, and the clamps are to be get taken off. The pattern is taken off. So after that, it is to be placed. So the same process, the two times is to be followed. So in a box, some sand is to be placed in between, the molten metal is to be get taken. After solidification takes place, so this is the final piece. Clear, students? So this is the final piece which is going to be getting. Okay. So that is going to be happen in a shell molding. Clear. So now we will move to the investment casting. So investment casting, the procedure is this one: the first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and seventh. So in an investment casting, it produces a very high surface quality and a dimensional accuracy. It produces very, very high surface quality and dimensional accuracy. So in the investment casting, the pattern is made up of a wax. It is made up of a wax. It is not a normal part. So investment casting is commonly used for precision equipment such as surgical equipments, for complex geometries, and for precious metals. So in an investment casting is mostly used for artwork, the gallery work. So that type of things, the investment casting can be used more and more. So this process is commonly used by the artisans to produce a highly detailed artwork. So the first process is to produce a pattern or replica of the finished mold. Wax is most commonly used to form a pattern, although the plastic is also used. So compared to the plastic, they are going to be using a wax. So that is the first part, the first thing. You are going to be taking a pattern, so you are going to pouring some wax in it. So you are preparing a wax pattern. So after that, the patterns are typically mass produced by injecting liquid or a semi-liquid wax into the permanent die. So I have told you. So you are going to be taking a permanent die. So with the help of permanent die, you are going to manufacture some wax pattern. So prototypes, small production runs, and specialty projects can also be get undertaken by carving wax models. So see the first step. The first step is a permanent die was to be get taken, and it is to be get dipped in some wax. So the wax pattern is to be get prepared. After that, some sprue is going to be taken. The sprue is also made up of a wax. So the sprue, it is going to be having a different gate systems. So for each and every gating system, the wax pattern is to be get attached. So after that, the total tree model is to be get dipped into some slurry. Some slurry is to be get used, and it is to be get dipped. So after dipping into the slurry, the second one is some stucco coating is to be get done. So stucco coating is nothing but it consists of some binder and then water consistent, so that the coating is to be done 3 to 4 times. It is not a single part. It is not a single part because the first coating is made up of some metal slurry. So the second coating is, it must be having a very thickness. It is not a very thin part. It must be having a very thickness. So that type of that, for that sake, a 3 to 4 times the stucco coating is to be get done. Clear. So after that, it is to be get heated. So the total tree is to be get heated with the help of some electric generators. It is to be get heated. So when the heating was done, the total pattern is made up of a wax. So when heating was done, the wax is to be get down. It is to be get melted. So each and every wax, which is consists of each and every part, it is to be get melted out. So the final shape we are going to be getting, that is, think it is nothing but one of the shell. So after the wax is to be get removed, the total tree is to be get placed and some molten metal is to be get poured. So which flows to each and every wax pattern, each and every shell. Each and every shell. So after some time, the solidification was done. So each and the total pattern, the tree pattern, is going to having some stucco coating. So after the solidification was done, each and every part is to be get bricked. And this is the 7th point, is nothing but you are the pattern, you are the product is to be getting. Clear, students? So these are the 7 steps are happening. So first one is permanent die. You are preparing the wax pattern. The second one is wax sprue is to be get taken. So the sprue is also made up of a wax. So for the wax sprue, some gatings are there. So for that gatings, the wax pattern is to be get handled. So the total tree shape is dipped in a some metal slurry. After that, it is to be again dipped into a stucco coating. So stucco coating is to be get carried over 3 to 4 times, so that the more thickness over the metal, more the metal is to be get happen. The metal is the first coating, the second, third and fourth is the stucco coating. So after that one, the total tree shape is placed and it is to be get heated. So when it is heated, the wax which is consisting is to be get removed. After that, in the pattern, the molten metal is to be get poured. So after molten metal is to be get poured and it is to be get solidified, each and every piece can be get take over. So this is nothing but an investment casting. Clear? So under this point, we will see the video, how it is, so that you can get understand easily. Step 1, molding of a wax pattern. So how the wax pattern is to be get mold. So these are the 2 permanent dies which are going to be used. So this is the gating system. So from where the wax is to be get poured. So wax patterns are produced by injection molding with a metal die. So wax patterns are to be removed. And next, the pattern assembly. So which I have told you, the sprue tree shape is to be get taken. The sprue is also made up of a wax. So for each and every gates, the wax pattern is to be get fitted. Assembly the patterns. So the slurry coating, the first one. So total tree is to be fitted. So tree is dipped into the ceramic slurry. So that is the first coating. So this is the second coating. It consists of a sand, some binders, and some water. The stucco coating. So this process is done 2 to 3 times, so that the thicker shell is to be get formed over the slurry coating. So first coating, so this is a second coating, so it is somewhat thicker compared to the first coating. This is the third coating. So there is a difference between a first and a third coating. The thickness is increasing when compared to the first one. So after that, the total tree is to be get heated. So this is the first part. So why the heating is, you are going to be melt the wax, which is made up of, the pattern is made up of a wax. It is to be get melted. So due to some heaters, it is to be get melted. So this is the wax which is to be get removed. So the sixth step is pouring of the metal. So we have removed the wax. So in the inner side, the wax is not there. So it is totally a shell. So molten metal is to be poured. So the sprue, which is having some gate systems. So through the gate systems, the wax patterns are to be get filled also. So the shell is filled with a molten metal by the gravity pouring. So everything was to be get poured. So solidification takes place for some weeks or some days. So seventh step, it is to be get shake and it is to be get breakdown. So the stucco coating is to be get removed. The stucco coating is the shake out from the final casting by the hand or a machine. So these are the final shapes which we are going to be getting. So if you want to remove the each and every pattern, each and every part, it can be get removed. So this is the final casting. So you can remove each and every part if it is needed as per your advantage. Clear? So this is nothing but your investment casting. So this is nothing but your investment casting. Clear, students? So the cores are typically unnecessary but can be used for a complex internal structures. So rapid prototyping techniques have been developed to produce the expendable patterns. So several replicas are often attached to a gating system constructed of the same material to form a tree assembly. In this way, multiple castings can be produced in a single pouring. So clear? So when you want to prepare a very small patterns, so it can be easily prepared by using an investment casting, because for a one sprue, different gatings are to be get there. So for each and every gating system, the pattern is to be get attached, so that with the help of a molten metal, what is to be get poured, the patterns, the products are to be get manufactured easily. So at one step you can prepare more number of parts. This is nothing but investment casting. So advantages is the parts of great complexity and intricacy can be cast. So some complex shapes, intricate shapes can be get casted easily. So the close dimension control and a good surface finish. So this also comes under the good surface finish, and it is also having a dimensional accuracy. When the same thing which we had seen in a shell molding also. So the wax can usually be recovered for reuse. So whatever the wax was drained out, it can be get reused for the next process. Okay, it is not a waste of. So the additional machining is not normally required. So the additional machining is nothing but the super finishing or fine finishing operations. It can't be get required. So this is a net shape process. Okay. So the disadvantage is many processing steps are required, relatively expensive process, and it is very lengthy process. The shell molding as well as investment casting, the both are a lengthy process because a number of steps are to be get required to complete your final casting. Clear? So as you had seen, the first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and a seventh. But it is having a good accuracy. It is having a good dimensional accuracy as well as a surface finish also. Clear, students? So this comes under the casting with a expandable mold. So students, one more thing, when you can understand easily, you can write in your own words also how the total process was carried out. So by writing in your own words, you can directly understand what are the different advantages, what are the different disadvantages can be getting by using each and every casting. So no need to learn also when you are going to be understand easy manner. So next one. So this is the plaster mold. So they didn't given a more stuff under the plaster mold. So but the plaster mold is nothing but a plaster Paris. It is a plaster Paris pieces how it is to be get manufactured. So it is nothing similar to the sand casting only, except the mold is made up of a plaster Paris. Except the mold is made up of plaster Paris. So here the plaster and a water mixture is poured over the plastic or a metal pattern to make a mold. So you are going to be using a plaster and a water mixture. It is to be get available in a market. So that is to be get mixed and it is to be get poured on the pattern which is going to be taken. And it is made up of a gypsum. The plaster of Paris is made up of a gypsum. This is a chemical compound which is to be explained under the plaster of Paris. So the advantages is the good dimensional accuracy and a good surface finish. It is also having a good dimensional accuracy. And it is very good appearance. It will be having a very good appearance. You can prepare a different number of colors pieces also by using a plaster of Paris. And it's very expensive. It is not a very cheap, it is expensive also. So capability to make thin cross sections in casting. Yes, you can make a very thin cross sections also in casting. And it is very lightweight and it is not easy to hold also. It is not easily hold because it is to be get take care of more. It is not easy because when the caring is not taken in a correct manner, it can be get break. So it is very thin part. It is not a very thicker part. So it is a very lightweight. It is not somewhat more weight. So what are the disadvantages? The moisture in a plaster mold causes problems. Yeah, I heard what I had told you. So used to see in your social media that the different persons in the family used to be dip their hands in a plastic molding basin. And after that, they used to be poured some cement mixture and some plaster mixture over the hands so that they used to get some type of shape from that mold. So that is also one of the casting process only, which is to be get taken care under the plaster molding. So that is the size is okay, the appearance is okay, but it is to be very delicate. The okay, it is to be get seen, but it is very delicate. So the mold must be baked to remove the moisture. So yeah, it is to be having a more moisture. So when the moisture is to be get removed, the strength will be get more. So when the to get a more strength, what is to be get done? The heat treatment is to be get done. So it is one of the part. So mold strength is lost when it is over baked. So when it is over baked, the strength is to be get lost. So at moisture content can cause defects in the product. So we will see, you used to see the different types of defects, the sprue holes, the cracks, the defects, the different types of absorptions which are going to be having on a workpiece. So that type of defects can be get seen on your workpiece. So plaster molds cannot stand for a high temperatures. So it cannot be used for a high temperatures. It is used for only a low temperatures. So we used to see in your homes when the ceiling was to be get done, the persons used to be buy some ceiling trays and they used to be get fixed to your wall. So it is having a only small length. It is not a full length. So a full long piece, it cannot be get carried out. Very small pieces is to be get manufactured. Clear? So these are the advantages and disadvantages. So compared to the plaster molding, it is made up of a plaster of Paris. It is not up to the mark. It is not to be used more in an industries also. It is for a show off purpose. Clear? And the next one. So clear, friends. So these are the things which comes under the sand casting, the shell molding, and as well as the investment casting and as well as the plaster molding. Okay. So as per your syllabus, we complete the different types of casting process. In a different type of casting process, we had completed just a three parts. One is the shell, the sand casting, the shell molding and investment casting, and a plaster casting. Okay. So in the next class, we will move to the another permanent casting and a centrifugal casting. So we will move to the next another part. So any doubts, friends? I had given a command to unmute yourself. You can unmute yourself and you can, if you, are you, do you have any doubts?